and spectators flocked to the circuit. And Eurosport were there too. We were there on the track with the bike of Jean-Pierre Schneider, Stefan Gabrielli and Alain Bronek, the number 24. Machine, the Yamaha YZF 750 was bearing our colours, but it wasn't going to win. This was the favourite, the number 8 Works Kawasaki, Dorje, Brian Morrison, yeah, and Pierre Giorgio Bontempi.
Qualify yesterday, the weather was not so good, so we are lucky to have a dry track in the afternoon. And Pierre Giorgio, he rides very well, and he made pole position for us.
So Brian Morrison looking forward to the Boldor, a race he's never won, but a race he'd like to.
I'm lucky because I don't have to score any points here. I am already world champion, so less pressure from the championship, but still some pressure for the race.
So Morrison, one of the favourites for this race, and there on pole, that's Terry Reimer preparing for the start. Just a few moments to go before the flag is waved. The charge across the track begins. And ahead of them, 24 hours of racing around this 3.6-mile Paul Ricard circuit. And as the field blasts away from the start, the clouds are already gathering. But a brilliant getaway for Philippe Mouchet, Michel Graciano and Gerard Moutu tow aboard their Honda. In fact, in the man in the driving seat for the first time around is Gerard Moutu. Not a good start for the number 9 Phase 1 endurance team. That's David Goodley there, and he's experiencing trouble right at the very start of this race. But into the lead goes William Cost aboard the factory Yamaha, the Works Suzuki behind him. Then the Works Yamaha, ridden by Jim Whittam, the man who's leading the Motorcycle News British Superbike Championship at the moment. And in fact, that bike in second place is the second of the two factory Suzukis. There are four different makes of Japanese bike, all Works bikes in the first four in these very, very early stages of the 1996 Boldor. Plenty of action on this opening lap. Crowded conditions out there on the track, making for some hectic opening laps as they charge down the Mistral for the first time. Let's see who it is that hits the front. There's the number 11 Kawasaki. That's the second Kawasaki factory bike of Stefan Kutel. And Whittam hits the front. Good news for the Brits as Jim Whittam hits the front of the Boldor field. Terry Reimer back there in fifth place as it is at the moment. And the distinctive style of the Yorkshireman normally rides the Cadbury's Boost Yamaha in the British Superbike Championship. But these early stages, just jockeying for position, trying to get a good start, get a good position in the early stages of the race so that they've got a clear road ahead of them. One lap completed, and it's Whittam that leads the factory Suzuki in second. But our poor girl catch a death of cold as she carries on like that. And it's Whittam leading in second place on the number 15 bike, Frederick Protard. In third place, it is the factory Kawasaki being campaigned by Pier Giorgio Bontempi. Then the Works Suzuki, ridden by Terry Reimer. But this Jim Whittam, and Whittam always an exciting rider to watch, and none more so than on this big endurance bike, the YZF 750 Kawasaki factory bike flown in from Japan especially for this race. And Whittam very highly regarded by the Japanese. Whittam takes a look over his shoulder to see what the score is. There's a breakaway group already, and the race only a couple of minutes old. So the 1996 Boldor is already underway, and that's the way it stands at the moment. Yamaha, Suzuki, Kawasaki, the second Suzuki, and the factory Honda, followed by the second of the two Kawasakis. All the Works bikes at the front of the field, as you would expect, after a couple of minutes. A couple of minutes is what it takes to do a lap of the Boldor circuit, and it's all happening out there at the front of the field. The Works bikes setting the pace, the rest of the field just settling down, and hitting the front is the factory Kawasaki. The works Kawasaki leads the Boldor as the field sorts itself out. Up into second place has gone Terry Reimer. Jim Whittam dropped back to fourth position at the moment, just behind the number two factory Suzuki. Whittam goes up the inside and takes over third place, but it's Bontempi on the Kawasaki that leads. Reimer in second place, Whittam is third, so good representation from the British up there at the front of the field. And Whittam having a great scrap with that second factory Suzuki. But it's the Kawasaki that leads, with Pier Giorgio Bontempi in the saddle, and up the inside goes Terry Reimer. Reimer dives through on the inside, absolutely fearless, and Reimer looking very good and very comfortable aboard that works Kawasaki. The works Suzuki. Reimer riding so many different bikes this year. He's campaigned, of course, the Lucky Strike Suzuki in the Grand Prix. It's an old Spice Ducati that he rides in the British Championship, and now he's aboard a factory Suzuki 750cc GSXR 750 in the final round of the World Endurance Championship, the Boldor. And already somebody in the pits in the early stages of this race. That's the number 91. That's Frank Giraudot, and experiencing just a few problems. So he's the first caller into the pits. Meanwhile, down the field, lots of other action going on. And it's still Reimer leading, Bontempi in second place. Suzuki leads Kawasaki, with Whittam in third spot. You'd just recognise that riding style anywhere, wouldn't you? Oh, and there's the Phase 1 Kawasaki, by the looks of it, in the pit. No, it's not. It's, I beg your pardon, it is number 60. That's the Toulon Superbike local team. And Patrick Guito, the man Patrick Macchio, the man in the pits there, fettling that machine. Oh, but that is the Phase 1 bike, the Kawasaki. Dave Goodley has got a few problems there. I don't know what his problem is, but Goodley already in trouble out there on the track. He's saying okay to one of the marshals at the trackside as the factory Kawasaki goes through. He's down in fourth place at the moment. Already they're coming up behind a few tail enders. That's Yeon Dorje. Well, in fact, it's not. What am I talking about? Dorje. That is Bontempi. Join us after the break. More action from the Boldor. Welcome back to our exclusive coverage here on Eurosport of the 1996 Boldor, the final round of the World Championship, which has already been decided in favour of Brian Morrison. But as you'll see, Morrison's Kawasaki squad out of the race. Yeon Dorje riding at the time a rear wheel problem. They broke the spindle of the rear wheel and couldn't get the bike going again. He lasted just 28 laps, and that's no good in a race when you're expected to do more than 600 of them. So leading the race at the moment is Peter Goddard aboard the works Suzuki. 4 hours in now, and Peter Goddard doing a fine job. Terry Reimer laid the foundations with a splendid first session, and he set an absolutely blistering pace. And it's Goddard now that is picking up that pace, having taken over aboard this works Suzuki. There's the standings after 4 hours and 6 minutes. Suzuki leading, Kawasaki on their second bike in second place. The factory Honda is third. The second of the two Suzukis in fourth place. Yamaha, including Jim Whittam in that team, in fifth spot. And the number one bike of the Elf Ghinia Bode Honda team of Mattioli, Simeon and Gigu in completing the lineup in sixth place. And Goddard looking very, very smooth and extremely competent out there on the track. Oh, and now that's the factory Kawasaki, and that has a problem. Yeah, there was a definite look, and that's Stefan Kutel, the only man that could equal Morrison on points. He's in the other Kawasaki team, but he's run out of petrol by the looks of that, those antics there. Running out of gas, well, I never. And he's near the beginning of a lap too, so he's got a heck of a way to push. If he is to get back into the fray, Stefan Kutel on the number 11 bike, the blue armbands, and he is back into, well, into some heavy pushing if he's to get back to the pits. I can tell you that he's telling the marshals, by the looks of it, no, he's shaking his head, he's telling the marshals, don't help me, I've got to push the thing back by myself. And that's a hell of a push from where he's run out, I can tell you. But that's a definite bit of a mismanagement from the team, I would say, not very good at all. As we found out from Christian Bourgeois, the team manager of Kawasaki. He's saying, yeah, there's no more fuel in the bike, but these things can happen for us. He's lost a lot of time, but Stefan had never run before at the Boldor with this team, and he used more fuel than the others, so that's racing. Well, Stefan Kutel doing his best to try and slosh the fuel around and make sure he can get as far as he can, but he's obviously pretty disgusted there with the fact that he can progress no further aboard that factory Kawasaki, and that is going to cause him all sorts of problems. And just look at the body language there, he's not very happy as he trudges back towards the paddock a long, long way. The fight for the places carries on out there as the dusk begins to gather. That is the factory Honda of the number 3 bike being campaigned at the moment by Christian Lavier. Lavier it is who's taking the factory Honda, currently lying in second position behind the Suzuki of Poland, Goddard and Reimer. Lavier's teammates, remember, Alex Vieira, former world endurance champion, and William Cost, who's been one of the leading lights in the Thunderbike Championship, Thunderbike Trophy, which is one of the supporting race, well, which is the main supporting race to the Grand Prix this year. And a scrap going on there between Lavier and number 7. He doesn't like it at all. Get out of the way. Move over. I'm coming through, he says. Well, how dare you hold me up, you varlet. And that's Francois Cicliani, who gets a swift boot up the backside. Meanwhile, this is the fight for third place between number 15, that second factory Suzuki, and the factory Yamaha. It's the Yamaha that's holding sway at the moment, running very, very wide there. Yeah, the battle between third and fourth, and as you can see, there's nothing in it. The number 4 bike ridden by Jean-Marc Delaton. And the number 15 Suzuki being campaigned by Damon Buckmaster, the Australian. It's Buckmaster and Delaton slugging it out for that third place. And this very difficult time as the light begins to disappear, the gloom begins to gather. Doesn't look that dark on this picture, but in fact it's a lot gloomier than it appears. And the bad news that these riders will be hearing as they head into the dusk, the gathering gloom, the mist of the Mistral Strait, is that later on this evening, thunderstorms are forecast for the Paul Ricard circuit, and none of them will relish the prospect of racing around this infamous 3.6-mile circuit, a circuit that's deemed to be too dangerous for Grand Prix to be held upon it. They use a different circuit for other races that they have here. World Superbikes and Grand Prix do not use the full circuit, which incorporates the Mistral Strait. It's a pity in a way, because it promotes some fantastic racing. But safety, of course, is always paramount, and no compromises can be made. Still that battle raging on between the Damon Buckmaster on the Suzuki and Jean-Marc Delaton on the factory Yamaha. This for third position. headlights ablaze, and the gloom gathering all the time as the sun goes down. You can see the clouds too. A massive wheelie there from Delaton. Somebody peels off into the pits, and it wasn't either of the factory bikes this time too. The funfair in the background going full pelt. You can see that's Christian Sarol, former world 250 champion, former factory Yamaha rider in the Grand Prix, and the team manager of the Yamaha Moto France factory effort here at the Boldor. And he's obviously waiting for Jean-Marc Delaton to come in. There'll be a change of rider, a fill up with fuel, probably a change, well, definitely a change of tyres, and possibly a change of brake pads too. They can accomplish all of that in round about 20 seconds or half a minute. And the battle for third place is raging on, but if Delaton is about to come into the pits, it could all change very, very shortly. It's still the Suzuki factory bike being ridden at the moment by Peter Goddard that leads this race. We were looking at the battle for third place, but there are similar battles going on all the way down the field. And what a spectacle this event is. The Boldor, one of the two-wheel classics, a race which anybody that's interested in bike racing should attend at least once. It's a unique atmosphere, and it's hard to believe. I know the first time I went, I just couldn't believe they went so fast right from the start. I thought they'd pace themselves, but oh dear me, no. The only pace that they know is flat out. And Jean-Marc Delaton and Damon Buckmaster are flat out at the moment as they clock up yet another lap of the Paul Ricard circuit on their way to what they hope will be 600 and odd laps before the finish. Oh, and the hand goes up into the pits, is going the Yamaha. So the Suzuki, ridden by Damon Buckmaster, takes over second place. The crew is ready. They've confirmed that he's coming in. The fuel is ready. The board is ready for him to slam against. He stops. There's no problem there. The bike goes up on its jacks. The fuel is going in. Jamie Whittam is getting back aboard the bike. He gives the screen a wipe. The front wheel goes in. The new front wheel. That's done. He's out of the way. The bike is back down off its jacks. The bike fired into life. The factory Suzuki back out into the race. James Whittam makes his way slowly down pit lane. There is a speed limit in pit lane, and you can get done for speeding, for which there would be a stop-go penalty. But Whittam back into the fray as the spectacular sky over the Paul Ricard circuit shows you that it's getting very dark as they head off towards the night. And it's getting darker and darker by the minute. As if we needed any proof. There it is, at the moment, a gap in the clouds and the moon bathing the Paul Ricard circuit in its milky light. But rain is forecast around about 11:30. At night, and as you can see, the lightning storms are raging all the way around, and there is the white flag. That means that the pace car is out, and the problem is that there is oil on the circuit. Oil on the circuit following two accidents. One of them involving Serge Vieira, no relation to Alex Vieira, the former world champion, but a Kawasaki rider, Serge Vieira, who is taken to hospital, suffering from severe injuries. He's gone to hospital in Marseille, and the pace car is out. And the whole race under full course yellows, they just cruise around the track. And you can see there how dark it is. If it wasn't for that light on the white flag down in the out down on the Mistral Straight. Pitch black, absolutely pitch black. A few riders taking advantage to come into the pits. They can only rejoin at the back behind the pace car. But now can be the time to do it. The factory Suzuki squad is all ready, and the rain is coming down as well. And that will mean that the race is halted. The race is actually stopped. They need to change tyres. And there we are, Terry Reimer in the pits. That is the leading Suzuki. He has changed to wet tyres. Pace car is still out, but just look at the conditions. Could hardly be very, hardly be worse than that. The race isn't exactly stopped, but it's sort of put on hold while the pace car is out. And as you can see, conditions that nobody would savour. Now, during the night, there is a bit of trouble because the race, in fact, the red flag is out and the race is stopped. It's halted for around about 2 hours and all the bikes go into the Parc Fermé. It stopped at 6:10 in the morning. By this time, the factory Suzuki has gone out of the reckoning after suffering a broken rear axle. The suspicion is that the rear axle wasn't put in properly, either wasn't put in properly, or that rider Doug Polan, who was just climbing aboard, set off before the team was ready. And you can hear the torrential downpour of the rain. And this was to become a recurring theme of the Boldor 1996. After a stoppage of some 2 hours and 10 minutes, the race was due to get back underway at 09:30 on a much brighter and a much more promising looking Sunday morning. And the race is underway. Terry Reimer not in contention though. They've gone out. In fact, of course, I'm completely mistaken because Terry Reimer hasn't gone out yet. That is to come. Terry Reimer still very much in contention, and at this stage is still campaigning the Suzuki, but I've jumped the gun a little bit for you. I hope I haven't spoiled it too much. Those of you who have been watching our live coverage will know anyway that Reimer has troubles in store, and so does the factory Suzuki squad. But I do apologise for getting my chronology a bit awry. It's been a long, hard weekend keeping up with our coverage of the Boldor. So let's get it right as we replay the restart. The factory Honda back into the fray at the head of the field. He got a good start. And the two Suzukis are sandwiching the factory Honda. And we'll have a look in a few moments' time and bring you up to date with the way things stood as they got underway. 13 hours of the race, well, that's what they're heading towards, 13 hours of the race having been run. Terry Reimer third on the track at the moment, but in actual fact leading with the Work Suzuki squad, and the number 15 bike being ridden there by let me see, that is Eric Gomez. Gomez it is that leads on the road with the factory Honda in second place, and the second of the two Suzukis, which rather confusingly is actually leading this race at this stage, is in third spot on the road. I hope you've kept up with all that. I'm sorry to make it a little more confusing for you than I needed to have done by jumping the gun on the Suzuki retirement. So Eric Gomez on the factory Suzuki is setting the pace and keeping those Suzuki hopes alive. Suzuki have had one or two troubles with the factory GSXR in the World Superbike Championship in getting it to handle correctly, but here at the Boldor it's certainly acquitting itself extremely well. It's Gomez leading. And in second place, the red armband of William Cost on the factory Honda. In fact, well now, according to this, the number two bike has already gone out of the lead. Change of rider in the Yamaha squad, and I think what everybody needs to do is ignore everything that I've said so far and let me recap that the true situation is that the factory Suzuki being ridden by Doug Poland, Peter Goddard and Terry Reimer has not gone out of the race, but it has lost 18 minutes in the pits, and that is what has put it down the order. Meanwhile, the other factory Suzuki comes in. Damon Buckmaster climbs back aboard, and out into the fray it goes. Through the chicane at the end of the pit lane and back out onto the track. So just to confirm that, there was a problem with the rear wheel spindle. It was replaced. There was an incident which resulted in a broken swinging arm, and they lost 18 minutes replacing it. This is the factory Honda, and the factory Honda is leading the race. this, the factory Honda being ridden by Alex Vieira at the moment, and that's how much they slacken off the pace when they put on the wet tyres. Alex, well, that's quite interesting. According to his armband, it should be Alex Vieira. It says Lavier on the back. And that is indeed Lavier aboard the leading number three factory Honda. It's a bit of an oil flag there. There's some problem. Somebody's dumped a bit of oil in the pit lane. Meanwhile, out of the race has gone the Phase 1 Kawasaki team. They've gone out with a broken engine. So that's a bit of British interest that has disappeared from the proceedings. And that is Christian Lavier, who is leading the 1996 Boldor aboard that factory Honda. RC45 works by, it's lovely to watch a bloke work, isn't it? Lavier, it is that leads, and you can see what the condition is like. 386 laps after 14 hours. Honda, Suzuki and Yamaha, the 1-2-3. Suzuki, Honda, 4 and 5. But this, the race leader. Factory Suzuki, number 2, in slow-mo. Heading down the Mistral Strait. Head down, a lot of time to make up. But going about it in exactly the right fashion, and that's Terry Reimer again, I think, on the number 2 bike. Indeed it is. Reimer, a very impressive showing in this race. None of the riders like riding in the wet if they can help it, but seemed to matter too much to Terry Reimer. He set a blistering pace early on, then the bike, or the team, hit trouble during the night and had a few problems, but now back in the thick of the action with time to make up, and they'll be trying as hard as they possibly can. Unfortunately for them, so too will the Honda. 14 hours, 49 minutes gone. Honda, Suzuki and Yamaha, and 5 laps down now, with 400 laps in total completed. 5 laps down is the bike that led for so long, the factory Suzuki. This, the race leading factory Honda, and Christian Lavier, the man aboard. Christian Lavier about to give it up to somebody else, because he's calling into the pits a fresh set of tyres. They fill up with fuel and a fresh rider for the race leading works Honda. And this, have a look at this, this is how a fuel stop should happen. Very slick professional team, everybody with a job, all waiting. And there we go. The bike is on its jacks, the front wheel is out, the front wheel is back in, the pads are relocated, the new rider is aboard, that's Alex Vieira, and 20 seconds later, the bike is back out on the track. So, still leading the race, the factory Honda, and now, thanks to that incident in the night, with the factory Suzuki, the Honda in with a real chance of being victorious in this 1996 Boldor. Into the pits comes the works Yamaha. The works Yamaha with Jean-Marc Deloton in the saddle at the moment. Cruising slowly down pit lane. Definitely doesn't need a stop-go penalty at this stage. They're already, again, yet another well-drilled factory team. Deloton staying aboard, but he's going to have a change of crash helmet. The crash helmet is changed so that he can have a clear view. Nice and clean. He wants it taped up so that no rain can get down the slot. Everything's all changed, and back out into the race he goes. Jean-Marc Deletant rejoins the fray, and a very wet fray it is too at the moment. The rain still continuing to fall at the Paul Ricard circuit as the various crews wait for their charges to come in, and that is just how wet it is. And it's amazing what angles of lean can be achieved in conditions like that. Just look at that front wheel. Absolute mastery by man of machine. And the Boldor splashing towards its conclusion. Join us for that conclusion after the break. The Boldor, and back at a very wet race. A race in which the pace car has been out almost as much as some of the riders, but the pace car is out again. The race, the torrential rain yet again falling on the Paul Ricard circuit. 45 minutes this pace car has been out, but hopefully it's about to restart again. Just keep an eye on proceedings as it is at the moment, but must be very frustrating for the competitors. Yeah, the pace car pulls off. The race is back underway. And still everything to play for among the top contenders. And the Suzuki there with the blue armbanded Eric Gomez in the saddle, splashing through the Paul Ricard puddles on the Le Castelet circuit. And steadily making up ground is the other factory Suzuki too, following that problem earlier on in the race. Problems there for number 60 in the pits again. We caught a glimpse of him earlier on having all sorts of troubles. That's the Toulon Superbike machine of Guite Macchio and Venturini. That's the race leader. Number 3, factory Honda, still way out front in this race. Vieira, Lavier and Cost are the men in the saddle, and that is Cost, if I'm not very much mistaken. William Cost, who's done an absolutely splendid job in this French Honda team, the Honda France Elf team, it's called. The RC45 has never missed a beat. It's been absolutely consistent. Other teams have struck problems. Kawasaki hit trouble, so too did Suzuki, and the Suzuki back up to third place now, four laps down on the race leaders. And on the same lap now, the Honda and the Castrol Suzuki in second place. 426 laps completed. And lots going on in the Suzuki camp. There has been a crash. Somebody has been off. That is Eric Gomez, in fact, that's crashed the Suzuki. And hectic work in the pits to repair the broken bits, to knock everything back into shape, to get the Suzuki back into the fray. And that will lose it a lot of ground, I think. And that will probably enable, depending on how much ground it loses, may well enable the other Suzuki to claw its way back up into second place. But no doubt about who's leading. It's still the factory Honda out front. One hours of this race gone now. Oh, and what disappointment on the faces of the riders in the Suzuki squad. Great disappointment after all the hard work. Eric Gomez tumbling off. It's hardly surprising. The only surprising thing is there haven't been more incidents of a similar nature during this race, because the conditions have been absolutely atrocious. And the bad news is there's a bit more rain forecast too before the end. So there is a great debate as to whether the 1996 Boldor will eventually run its full distance. There have already been a number of stoppages, and they certainly can't stop it and restart it again. 15 still in the pits. Waiting there to go out is Frederick Protat. Helmet on, he's the next rider aboard. Checking to see what's bent and what's touching that shouldn't be. Are they calling for the... they're calling for another air duct there. Meanwhile, untroubled by all that frantic activity, William Cost proceeds on his steady way out on the circuit itself. He's not bothered by what's going on there. There is no problem as far as he's concerned. Meanwhile, number two up into second place. The man in the saddle at the moment is the Australian Peter Goddard. Peter Goddard up in the second spot on that factory Suzuki, which led this race for so long until a cracked swinging arm caused them to lose a lot of time and put them back down to second place. So Peter Goddard clocks up yet another lap. And it's obviously been a good team, this. Doug Poland, Terry Reimer, and Peter Goddard. The bike certainly looks nice and stable and steady. And I think as the development work continues on this factory Suzuki, then it can only get better and better as the quest for success carries on relentlessly at the top level in the World Endurance Championship, in the World Superbike Championship, and of course being campaigned now in the British Superbike Championship as well in the Motorcycle News series. So Peter Goddard up into second place at the expense of the other factory Suzuki, which shouldn't drop down too far. Should still be able to rejoin the race, hopefully in about third spot. Well, it's dropped down to fourth as it happens at the moment. 4:34 laps completed by the leaders after 21 hours and 28 minutes. And this, the style of Peter Goddard. And tramping on there is that Delaton, I think it is. That is in fact Adrian Morillas. Adrian Morillas aboard the factory Yamaha. And he's had the foresight to put on an oversuit, doesn't like getting too wet. And you can't say you blame him, really, can you? Keeping his leathers as dry as he possibly can. Or is that just a jacket that he's got on? Whichever way, it is flapping in the breeze. It does look suspiciously like just a jacket that he's got on there, but that will keep him a bit drier than his leathers would. They eventually get heavy and wet, and guess what, out comes the pace car once again. The pace car out on the track, brought out by the torrential rain. Raining harder than ever out there on the track. It's supposed to be sunny in the south of France, but storms all weekend have caused havoc, and that's been the story of the 1996 Boldor, a race that can usually be relied upon to provide a bit of sunshine. Lots of bikers make the trip down to near Toulon, where the Paul Ricard circuit is situated, in search of some September sunshine. And it's going to be a long, hard, wet ride home for them. Who'd be a marshal, eh? You You get to stand out in the rain all weekend, and your only reward is being allowed to wave the white flag every now and again. Well, it's surrender for everybody, I should think. 13 hours and 54 minutes. God, I think that might be a bit of a mistake there. I think it might be 23 hours and 54 minutes. But factory Honda leading, factory Suzuki's second and third, and the works Yamaha in fourth position. The second, third and fourth people just four laps behind the race leader. Look at that, rivers of water flowing around the circuit. It is so wet, and there's a man, he's going to break into a dance routine in a minute, singing in the rain. The white flag signifies that the pace car is out on the track, and they're just debating with the team managers now as to whether they should call a halt to the proceedings or not. The race director has to take consultation. The spectators are certainly fed up with it. They've spotted the camera, so that's cheered them up a bit. It must be a pretty soulless experience for them at the moment, but they seem pretty cheerful nonetheless, happy enough to get on TV. And indeed, the red flag is being ready. The director of the race director's obviously taken the decision that in the interests of safety, proceedings need to be brought to a halt. 58 minutes short of its scheduled stopping time at 3 o'clock. The 1996 Boldor is about to be red flagged. And nobody really could blame them for taking that decision. The red flag is shown on the start and finish line. You can see how pleased the competitors are that that decision has been taken. They probably wondered why it wasn't taken a bit sooner, but it can't have been much fun for them in the certainly in the late stages of this 24-hour race. So the Boldor 1996 gets the red flag. The race is halted, and it is a victory for the factory Honda squad. Well, it's a Boldor that will probably be remembered for all the wrong reasons, but not by these guys. They've won it. They're happy. Alex Fiera, Christian Lavier and William Cost victorious in the 1996 Boldor, and don't they look happy about it too. The final result, well, we'll be bringing you that in just a few seconds' time. But reflecting back on it, I'm sure Suzuki will be disappointed that things went wrong for them in the pits. And they lost that time because they were looking as if they were on target for a good victory. The usual Paul Ricard circuit invasion takes place, and as we await the podium, 457 laps then to the leaders, three laps behind Suzuki, the two Suzuki squads and the Yamaha team, eight laps down the Honda Guigné Bordé squad, and so on down through the field, and the field quite significantly spread out this year. It's obviously been a very tough Boldor, the weather conditions not terribly conducive to close, exciting wheel-to-wheel racing, and in fact three laps is not a very wide margin at all. So to the victors, the spoils, and to the Honda team, the famous Golden Bowl, the Boldor. You see, there's Terry Reimer as a member of the runner-up team with Doug Poland and Peter Goddard. Suzuki in third spot. Also with Gomez, Prota and Damon Buckmaster, the Australian. Plenty of celebrations going on the track as we talk to the victorious Alex Vieira.
Vraiment, c'est une très très grand plaisir pour toute mon équipe et moi-même.
Yeah, said he's very happy for his team and for himself. For me, he says it's his last Boldor, his last race, and he's finished it with a victory, and that's wonderful.
C'est vrai que c'est le meilleur intégral, ça fait 10 ans que
Christian Lavier,
le 8e sur Moto de Vichy.
It's a beautiful victory, he said. It's 10 years now that he's been competing in the Boldor. It's very hard and he appreciates this victory. Well, a few wet, bedraggled, and I would say pretty damn miserable spectators making their way home, but there's still something to smile about for the spectators, for the winners of the 1996 Boldor. Well, I hope you've enjoyed our coverage. Please don't be too hard on me for my mistakes earlier on. I'm Paul Fowler, and it's goodbye from the 1996 Boldor.